Hello everyone and welcome. In this video we're going to be talking about why electric cars have peak torque available from 0 RPM or a complete standstill. And recently I attended Drive Revolution where I was able to check out a bunch of different hybrid and electric vehicles, and the Chevy Bolt actually won the Northwest Green Car of the Year award, and I think that was well deserved. One of the cool things about electric cars is that, you know, they're doing something that you hear a lot about in marketing terms now. So a lot of companies are saying, hey, we're able to achieve peak torque at just 2000 RPM or 1500 RPM. All these companies are trying to, you know, bring down when you get peak torque available in the engine range for internal combustion engines, because they know that's a more responsive, more fun to drive vehicle. And electric cars actually do this the best because they have that peak torque available from 0 RPM. So in city environments, you know, where you're maintaining these low speeds, they're actually a ton of fun because you always have that peak torque available. So how are they able to do this? Well, basically we're going to talk about motors, generators, and then get into why that peak torque is available at 0 RPM. So if you haven't already, I have a bunch of different videos on how electric motors work. This is going to be a very generic overview. So if you want more details, check out the links in the video descriptions. I have quite a few videos on this subject. But very basically, how a motor works is you supply a current through a wire, which is going to be your motor ultimately. You have a magnetic field, so you've got north to south magnetic field traveling right here. And so as that current travels through that wire, within that magnetic field, it's going to generate a force to rotate that wire there. So basically rotate the motor. The armature of the motor is going to start to spin. And this is covered by Fleming's left-hand rule. Now, old convention states that current travels from positive to negative. Electrons are actually traveling in the opposite direction, but that's the convention. So using Fleming's left-hand rule, if you line up the field with your pointer finger, your force, or your current rather, with your middle finger, then your thumb is going to point the direction of the force. And so as you can see there, field, current, force, so it's going to force that to rotate. So the more current you apply to this copper wire, the more it's going to want to spin and will spin faster and faster. Now a generator is basically doing this in reverse, and so as a result the current is going to be in the opposite direction. But basically you're going to be rotating the armature, so spinning that copper wire through that magnetic field, and so you use Fleming's right-hand rule because this is in reverse. So if you have the field coming from your pointer finger, you've got your current with your middle finger, and then your thumb will show you the force. Your thumb is, of course, as a result of turning that clockwise. So you're creating that force, you have the magnetic field, and then you're going to have that current be created in that clockwise direction there. So you can see that's the opposite of right here. Okay, now these two are actually happening simultaneously. So when you supply that current, you're going to start spinning this motor. But because you're spinning the motor, you're going to have a back voltage in the opposite direction. So it kind of goes back and forth. Yes, you supply the current, you spin that motor up, but once you have a spinning motor, the rotation of that motor creates this back EMF, or electromotive force. So the two occur simultaneously, and the faster you spin up this motor, the more back EMF you're going to have. And so, you know, you've got your current here from north to south, just like this. It's the exact same scenario, but basically you have to keep in mind that once this is spinning, as it rotates, it's acting somewhat like a generator, and as a result, it has that back EMF. So your working voltage is equal to your supply voltage minus your back EMF. So just a quick example, let's say you had a working voltage of 120 volt outlet, you plug in, it starts spinning up, and you've got a back EMF of 100 volts, so your working voltage is just 20 volts. Now this explains why you have peak torque available at 0 RPM, because back EMF is only occurring once this is actually rotating. So the faster you spin it up, the more back EMF you have. So when it's not rotating at all, you have no EMF, no back EMF. And as a result, all of the power that's going into it is creating torque. And so, you know, you may notice this, for example, if you turn on a vacuum cleaner in your house, and the lights will dim very quickly, but then they'll come right back after the vacuum cleaner is spinning up. So what's happening there is right when you turn that vacuum cleaner on, the voltage requirement, the current draw from the vacuum cleaner is really high because you don't have any back EMF. You're not spinning it up yet, so you have a huge current draw to spin up that electric motor. Then once the electric motor is rotating, its actual working voltage is much lower as a result of the back EMF, and you see your lights very quickly come back to their normal levels. So you get full torque available at zero RPM. That's because you're not spinning. You don't have this generator effect of the motor, which is kind of working against you in your working voltage. And so basically what happens is however much power you supply, that motor is going to find an equilibrium where it spins up to a certain speed where the back EMF and your resistance to, you know, moving forward in the case of a car, aero drag, things like that, are equal, and so you're going to be at a certain speed at that point. Your back EMF plus the resistances from, you know, driving, rolling resistance, things like that, equal each other out, and you're at a set speed. You supply more power, you increase your speed. But ultimately, when you're at zero RPM, you give it full power. There's no back EMF because it's not actually spinning, and as a result, you have peak torque, and then that torque starts to taper off with RPM. So thank you guys for watching. As mentioned, I have plenty more videos on, you know, how electric motors work, AC, DC, that kind of thing. If you'd like to check those out in the video description. If you have any questions or comments, feel free to leave them below. Thanks for watching.